Hello friends, so far we have discussed digital to analog converters and their performance characteristics. Now we are coming on to analog to digital converters, ADCs. So first type is flash type or comparator type. So because we have already discussed in the previous classes that how does a comparator work and how it can compare two input signals and generate only two outputs. So it will give us the comparison of two inputs in the output, and that basic property of the comparator will be used in this flash type or parallel comparator. So let's come over to the block diagram that how many comparators are required in a comparator with number of bits on the input side is equal to 3. So general expression is 2 raised to power n minus 1 comparator, where small n is number of bits on the input side of the ADC. If number of bits on the input side of ADC is 3, then 2 raised to power 3 minus 1, that indicates it is 7. So it is like this, 2 raised to power n minus 1. So this is 7 number of comparators will be required to implement ADC 3-bit to converter, analog to digital converter, 3-bit converter. So in this case, we have taken up comparators, 7 number of comparators, and this is the priority encoder whose working is given by this table. And on input side, we have connected a 8 volt, and below is analog input. See the connection diagram. Input is always connected to the inverting terminal, and same input is connected to all inverting terminals of the comparators. But there is a difference. The voltage with which we are making comparison in case of each comparator is differing, and we have created this circuit so that different voltages are connected to each of the comparator circuit, and that network is this. This is working on the basis of potential divider law. Here 8 volt is connected and 1k resistance, so it is coming 7 volt, 1k resistance, 1k, 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 1k and 1k. So there are 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 resistances of 1 kilo ohm resistance value, and accordingly we can calculate how much is the voltage available here. So here we note that 8 volt is connected at this end, this resistance is 1k, so this resistance is 1k, and this point to ground, how much is the total resistance of the on this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so 7k is the total resistance. So from this point to this point, how much is total voltage applied? That is the voltage we are calculating here. So this voltage is called VO. So this VO in this case will be equal to across which resistance we are calculating voltage, across 7k, so 7k is coming on the top, divided by total resistance of the path. Total resistance of the path is 8 kilo ohm. So 7k divided by 8k into 8 volt. So 7k divided by 8k into 8 volt will be equal to 7 volt. So here will be coming 7 volt. And similarly, you can make a comparison here also that it is coming out to be 6 volt, because what is the total resistance between these two points, this point and this point? Total resistance here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6k divided by total resistance of the path, 8k, and how much is total voltage applied? 8 volt. So this will be equal to 6 volt. Similarly, you can calculate input voltage at the non-inverting terminal, each of the non-inverting terminal. So 1 volt, 1 volt, 2 volt, 3 volt, 4, 5, 6, 7 volt. Now, output of each of the comparator is given as input to the priority encoder. Let us say analog input is 0.9 volt. Then this is 0.9 connected here, and it is 1 volt connected here. This line is connected to 1 volt. So 1 volt here, this indicates output will be positive or negative. Now it depends upon on which terminal voltage is large. On non-inverting terminal, that is positive terminal, voltage is large, so output will be positive. Here 0.9, 2 volt, because non-inverting terminal voltage is large, so output will be positive. 0.9, 3 volt, output will be positive. 0.9, 4 volt, output will be positive. So output in all the cases will be positive. Here we see that positive output, positive output, positive, 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 positive. So when input applied is less than 1 volt, input applied is less than 1 volt, then output is positive for I1 to I7. In that particular case, B2, B1, B0 value will be 0, 0, 0. So this is how your priority encoder is working. Now let us take second. Let us say analog input is 1.2 volt. Then this will be 1.2 volt. This is 1 volt, so output will be negative here. And in this case, this is 2 volt, this is 1.2, so output will be positive, 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 positive. So this will be 2 volt, this will be negative, all others will be positive outputs, and hence output of the priority encoder will be 001. This is how this priority encoder is designed. Then third case, let us say 2.2 volt. In case of 2.2 volt, this output will be negative, this output will be negative, positive, 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 positive. So negative, negative, all others positive, 0, 1, 0, and so on till 1, 1, 1, output can be produced. So this is how your flash type or parallel comparator functions. If somebody asked how many clock cycles does this hardware takes to produce output, then let me tell you, this is the fastest analog to digital converters that we have. Fastest, though it requires large amount of hardware to generate output, hardware requirement is more, but it is the fastest one. And if this circuit is implemented using a sequential circuit, then it can generate output in single clock cycle. And later on you'll realize that all other ADCs require more clock cycles than the flash type or parallel comparator. This is the fastest one that we have. Thank you.